on GSN.
Get set, Jim Fletch on Family Feud, Battle of the Bathing Beauty. For the mermaid, Susie Fawcett, Gina Puzo, Trisha Pillsbury, Debbie Chase, and Ashley Ray. Ready for action. And for the Neptune, Joseph Self, Robbie Gomez, Sean Cheek, Anthony Kutanen, and Cameron Arnett. On your mark, for the splashdown in Family Feud's Bikini Festival, the star of Family Feud, Surfer Ray Cohn.
It's our Bikini Festival right here on the Family Feud. If you've been watching, you've had to love this special all week. 10 or 11 of the most beautiful people that you've ever seen in the world. You pick them out. 5 of them right now are lovely women right here, headed by Trisha Pillsbury. 5 lovely women we're calling the mermaids. Into the summer season, these are the 5 girls everybody tries to look like, including a few of the guys I know. Hollywood. Who did you bring with you, Trisha, to help you defeat these men here today for $10,000?
My mermaid sister, this is Susie next to me.
Yes.
Next to her is Ashley.
Yes.
And this blonde here is Debbie, and at the end is Gina.
We welcome you. We saw you up front. Very fine work. We'd like the $10,000, but a lot depends on these 5 gentlemen, the Neptunes, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Robbie Gomez. Robbie has a commentary. You're going to what, Robbie?
We're going to tear them apart.
No.
Yes, we are.
I should do the same thing myself, Robbie. You think you could beat them? I'm kidding. Just kidding, folks. A joke. I went for it. Who'd you bring to help you defeat them is what you mean.
This is Tony, Joe, Sean, and Cameron.
Tony? All right, we're going to get to meet them all as we play the game. No sense wasting words. It's time to play the Feud. First team to 300 is going to play for $10,000. Good luck to both. The top 7 answers are on the board. We have 100 people this first question. Try to find the most popular answer. This. When kids finally move out of the house, name something specific they often leave behind. Robbie?
Their parents.
He said? The parents. It's not there. Now listen, Trisha. When kids finally move out of the house, name something specific they often leave behind. Parents?
Their room?
She said their room. I thought she meant for sure, Jiminy Cricket, the actual one out the door. Show me their room. Well, don't move, don't move. What do you say, Anthony? What do you say when kids finally move out of the house? Name something specific they often leave behind.
A blender.
Anthony says that our survey said when kids move out sometimes, specific they leave behind a blender. Like hope, Susie, that you know this answer. Before you speak, please listen to the question. We ask 100 people. When kids finally move out of the house, think something specific they often leave behind.
A stuffed animal.
Would it be stuffed animals to keep this question alive? Show it to me.
Thank you.
Number 1. Sorry, Robbie. Think of a spear. Think something specific they often leave behind. Right? Would it be their live pets, animals? There it is. Come on, Dad.
I like to leave my dirty laundry home.
Maybe somebody said dirty laundry. It's only one strike.
Their boyfriend or their girlfriend.
When you move out of the house, specifically you might leave your girlfriend or your boyfriend behind. I know that if I had moved out and left you, it would certainly make my father happy. You wouldn't even notice I left a blender. Let me see, you leave your boyfriend or girlfriend at your house. Two strikes!
Yes! Yes!
All right, it's 2 strikes. I know what you're thinking. Sure, they look good. Trisha, it's your turn to spell that over. We're also good looking and intelligent.
But no pressure.
No pressure.
They're bicycles.
You might forget when you move out your bicycle. $48 up for grabs. Cameron, one answer. When kids finally move out of the house, name something specific they often leave behind.
Books.
Books.
Linens.
Linens. Bed. Bed.
Television.
You tell Robbie what will steal you the first bank. Tell Robbie. You have five answers. For a call for call. I hear furniture. Television. It's up to you, Robbie.
Furniture.
He says furniture. $38. It's a start. So come here with furniture. I want you all to pay attention in case you do move out. Our survey said specifically, it's silly? No, the question is fine. Some of the answers were silly. Our survey said some kids leave this. Number two.
Tap.
Old clothes.
Yeah.
Or shoe.
Clothes and new clothes.
So they bargain, we'll take the $38 back, give it to them. Number five.
Five?
School memorabilia. And number six.
Six?
Boarding.
Not a chance.
That goes with it, but you keep your parents. Number seven.
Seven.
Books. The feud's begun. We're coming back. It's going to be a fun way for $300.
Seven.
Questions and surprising answers.
Does your digestive system feel irregular and good?
Top six answers are on the board. Name a place where you would see a lot of mirrors. Anthony?
A restroom.
He said, in a restroom.
Restroom?
Yeah.
Just there, three answers, Susan, to give you control. A place where you would see a lot of mirrors.
Circus mirror room.
The old circus mirror room. The circus fun house mirror room. Question posed to 10 very good-looking people to see who knows most, best, place where you'd see a lot of mirrors.
A mirror store.
Just when you think it's safe to get in the water, she said at a mirror store.
Yes! Yes!
It's not lame. Place where you would see a lot of mirrors.
I'm going to say a department store.
Will you stay away with department store? Strikes. $75 more. What do you say?
Oh.
You would see lots of mirrors and no?
Bedroom.
Bedroom?
Cosmetic counter.
Bedroom. Cosmetic counter.
Clothing.
Clothing store, bedroom. You tell Robbie what we'll steal.
Wait, no. I've got my own answer.
Quietly, he's going on his own. My Robbie says he's taking this bank with?
Jim. At a gym.
You would see lots of mirrors.
Yeah.
They're always there.
Yeah.
Did we make our survey? Gym.
Yeah. What?
The women. That was a good answer, but we heard Sean say bedroom. Anthony said blender. Sean said in a blender.
Blender, yeah, blender.
Lots of mirrors in number five on our survey. Logos. You actually said that, didn't you, Anthony?
Yes, I did.
And number six, a lot of mirrors. Dance studio. We're coming back. It's a real feud. It's 300 to play. See you in a moment.
Hey, children.
We ask 100 people, name a food that's hard to keep on your fork. Ashley?
Spaghetti.
Show me spaghetti. Just number two, possibly one answer could give you control, children. A food that's hard to keep on your fork.
I'm going to have to say salad.
Let me see. Salad. Is it number one? It's not even on. Think of a steal, guys. Our lovely ladies have control. The dollar value's doubled, Debbie. Listen carefully to the question. A food that's hard to keep on your fork.
Round vegetables.
Okay. A round vegetable. Now, I know that sometimes the judge would ask for a more specific answer, and he hasn't even done it in this case, but I'm curious which...
Around
one. Like maybe a zucchini, a gigantic...
No, like tomatoes.
Okay, just say, don't give away too many. The first one you said was a tomato. Happens to be a fruit. Thank you, Judge. But sometimes you never know. Let's see. A tomato. You said... What'd you say? I think stripe represented all vegetables. We don't want to take that to me. Didn't represent all vegetables, but just the brown ones. Gina, just tomatoes.
Peas?
Let me see. It's hard to keep on your fork. A pea. Show me pea. It's number one. I hope you understand, Deb, why he couldn't encompass all the vegetables. What are you saying, Trish?
Right.
She said it's hard to keep on your fork. Hey, let me see rice. Susie?
What was the question again?
Name a round vegetable that's hard to keep on your fork. A food that's hard to keep on your fork.
I'm going to say spinach.
Good answer.
You're still alive even if it's not there, spinach. Think of the steel, gentlemen. 178. That's it. She's concentrating.
Do it, Ashley.
You can do it, Ashley. A food that's hard to keep on your fork.
Soup.
Right. Judge, you don't need to know what kind of soup she's talking about. It doesn't matter what kind of soup. I think there's a good shot at you could still be alive. We see soup. That's right. Ashley, there were few of us that believed in you like I did. Don't try. I knew it was there. All I mean, I believed in you. I sense that they didn't believe in us. Come on, Dad, we can do it. One more answer, quickly.
Oh, no.
From the woman who gave us round vegetables, a food that's hard to keep on your fork for this bank.
Can you repeat the question?
I know I've done it. You can do it. Food that's hard to keep on your fork, 3 seconds.
Yes, do it.
Beans.
Like string beans. String beans.
String beans, okay. Do you take the bank with string beans? $184 in the air. Will you take it, man? A food that's hard to keep on your fork, Cameron?
Asparagus.
Snails. Jello.
Asparagus, snails, jello.
Ice cream.
Ice cream. You tell Robbie, tell him one answer. Right now. Robbie sometimes has 3 seconds.
Jello.
Goes with jello. Your $184 come to the man with jello. Nobody said. Here we go with another face-off right now. As we trip over the dollar now. The women can win this game. Possibly the men. Top 4 answers are on the board. We ask 100 people. Even though you may hate it, name something you eat only because it's good for you.
Broccoli.
Yes. She was saying it in time. Spinach. You see if it's on the survey. Spinach. Number 1. Think of a steal, Sean. A question. Dollar value's tripled and you can win this game. Even though you may hate it, something you eat only because it's good for you, Gina.
Bran?
Yes! Maybe it's up there. Show me Bran. It's a big bag, guys. Think of the steal. What do you say, Trish?
Great.
Good
question.
I could. Even though you may hate it. Name something you eat only because it's good for you.
Milk?
She said milk?
No!
Take the bag to win. You may hate it, but you eat it only because it's good for you.
I'm going to say carrot juice.
Good!
People do it. Carrot juice.
Yeah.
Ashley, not a better person for this whole game to pivot on. Keep it going, they can steal your bag. Even though you may hate it, something you eat only because it's good for you.
Liver.
Show me liver. Number 2. You can win the game. Debbie, if you give me number 3, you're going to play for $10,000. You may hate it, but you eat it only because it's good for you.
Fiber.
Yes!
Is it for the game? Fiber.
Delicious.
Gentlemen, if you don't know number 3, they're going to play for $10,000. Even though you may hate it, we ask 100 people substituted only because it's good for you, can't
broccoli? Broccoli?
Asparagus.
Asparagus.
Prunes?
Vitamins.
You tell Robbie what will save you in this game. One answer. Robbie, you have 3 seconds.
Prunes.
He says prunes. If it is not there, the women have won the game and are going to play for $10,000. Is number 3 prunes. Top 4 answers are on the board. I'm going to ask all players to listen carefully to this triple value question. We're going to move much quicker. Name a musical instrument with a keyboard. Gina? Cameron, name a musical instrument on the keyboard. He said, piano. Number 1, pick up a steel. Think of a steel. And musical instrument.
Now, question, is a piano the same thing as an electric piano?
Well, if it's a musical instrument with a keyboard, the jet says it's all inclusive.
Okay. How about an organ?
Let me see an organ. Number 2.
Xylophone.
Show me xylophone. Somebody offer $10,000 a chance at a musical instrument with a keyboard.
Synthesizer.
Let me see a synthesizer. I can't believe the judge knew what that was. Come on, Sean. You give me number 3. You're playing for $10,000. Musical instrument with a keyboard for the game.
Accordion.
Show me. Accordion.
Yeah.
Introducing Triple Flex from Nature Made.
Back to-
these current leaders, and you can see your name in life.
Sort of.
Log on to GSN.com now.
We're back with our handsome male models at our Bikini Festival. 15 seconds on the clock. As we go for $10,000, good luck, Joseph. We ask 100 people these 5 questions. Call me in the studio. Name a magazine that many men get subscriptions to as gifts. Something you might forget on a train or plane. Illustrated, the survey said. 44. Bam. Something you might forget on a train or a plane, you said. Luggage. What'd the survey say? 14, you're inching up. Common name for a dog, you said. Spot, survey said. 40. Place we asked for identification, he said. Survey said, bam, 35. Your favorite sport to watch on TV, you like football. The survey,
give him a big number.
49. There goes his shoe. The ball comes in, Joseph, back from the teammates. Here comes the partner, Sean. Sean, your 18 points for $10,000. That shoe belongs to your partner, Joseph. Get back under that rail. You look straight ahead, Sean. Clear the shoe just in case we don't want anybody hurt. Put 20 seconds back on the clock, revealing the wonderful answers. 18 points for $10,000. We ask 100 people, name a magazine that many men get subscriptions to as gifts. Something you might forget on a train or plane. A common name for a dog. A place where you're asked for identification. Bar. Try again. Your favorite sport to watch on TV. Turn around. 18 away. Look at Robbie. A magazine that many men get subscriptions to as a gift, you said? Playboy. I'll tell you, if just 18 people said it, you got $10,000. What did the survey say?
Survey said?